Yo, what's good, Tristans?
Answers from...
Today, we're going to be reacting... Oh, my goodness. So this is the importance of sending me interesting stuff. Whether you tag me on TikTok, Instagram, or you let me know over my Patreon, where I'm reacting to the entirety of High School Musical, the musical, the series, by the way. This is why it's important, because... I mean, this is just so... This is getting out of hand. I thought it was just the Zoomers coming for Olivia, but turns out it's also the goddamn Boomers. In fact, I think the Boomers are a little bit more brutal than the Zoomers at this point.
Oh.
People are out of their minds. They're out of their goddamn minds. But before we get started, today's video is sponsored by Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of different courses with members across 150 different countries. Just about whatever topic you're interested in, ranging from photography, videography, drawing, art, productivity, blah, 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 gardening even. Skillshare's got a class on that for you. So for example, I've been trying to learn how to draw on tablets because I'm trying to learn how to make charts because I want to start using more charts in my videos. And I'm thinking about making my own little online singing course and I want to have beautiful, accurate charts. So what did I do? I jumped over to Skillshare and I found that they had a course on Procreate, which is the exact app that I've been trying to learn how to use. And it's been fantastic. I just learned how to set it up and all this stuff and do all the basic things that I kind of skipped and I didn't realize I needed to do. But regardless of whatever it is that you're interested in, Skillshare can help make your 2022 a year of learning, growth, and creativity. So if you're looking for some ad-free courses to help you along your journey, click the link down in that description because the first 1,000 people to click that link down below will get a 1 month free trial of Skillshare, which launches new premium classes every single week with subtitles in languages like Spanish, French, Portuguese, and German. So what are you waiting for? Check that link down in the description below to help support the channel. And thanks again, Skillshare, for sponsoring this video. Okay, so on Olivia Rodrigo's Facebook page, she posted a promo for her singing Deja Vu, which I reacted to, by the way, on her NPR Tiny Desk. I reacted to the entire thing. I thought she sounded pretty good. I thought she sounded exactly like the album, exactly like the songs. And I thought the way she approached most of it was pretty dang good, to be quite honest with you. But the boomers over on Facebook don't think so. Oh my god. I am so tired of making these videos. This is what she uploaded, right? My band and I went to the DMV for NPR Tiny Desk. Blah, 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 blah. Great. Good job. Awesome. Good. Let's check out the clip.
So when you're gonna tell her we did that too, she thinks it's special.
Okay.
But it's so reused, that was the show we talked about. Played you the song she's singing now when she's with you.
Okay. That's good, right? I mean, I don't know what to say. That's fine. She sings the song. The song sounds like the track. The track was good. What's wrong with that? So we're going to start addressing some of these comments here. I'm loving these types of videos, you guys. If you love these types of videos, drop a like down below. Okay. By the way, please do not attempt to find, contact, or harass anybody mentioned in this video. Even though all of the people in this video have public profiles that commented on a public post, I've gone out of my way to protect everyone's privacy. So don't be a jerk. Don't try and find them. Let this just be a fun video, please. Thank you very much. She really does have a lovely voice and she is so talented. Yes. Sounds like someone herding a cat. Really? 257 reactions. The positive ones, 56, 42, 34. This, it really sounds terrible. She has potential, but voice lessons would be great. Voice lessons would be great. I love her music, but this was funny. She's a really good singer in other live videos, but she was a little off in this one. A little? There's so many. There's so many like this. Nope, don't care for, sucks. My goodness, please. You are so sour, so bad. Does this guy have any singing? Am I allowed to show people's faces? I mean, I feel like I can even blur this out and you have a pretty damn good idea what this guy looks like. Goddamn thumb out here telling people that they're bad. I don't know what's worse, the singing or all these people who think it's good. This person has a heart as their profile picture. Holy shit. The only thing cringier than TikTok is Facebook comments. Nails on a chalkboard. This person has a picture of a bathroom sink as their profile picture. Apparently they are some sort of plumber. Okay, no offense, but what is this?
What's wrong with that?
Bruh.
It's a face.
Needs a little filtering so it isn't so flat and off key. Filtering? Ordinary voice, average talent, but not very good. Some singers just need audio filters and sound enhancement, like sound airbrushing, etc. This person posted a status. Please, please, stop posting so many church memes.
Oh my god, dude, I cannot.
You know what I think it is? I've started to realize this. I think that if there's an artist, particularly if it's a female artist, but generally, if there's an artist that's popular amongst a young female demographic, everyone has something negative to say about them, regardless of the reality of their actual voice and their technique. Because their singer's worse than Olivia, their singer's on the same level as Olivia, but they don't get a fraction of the same negative attention. You saw it with Justin Bieber when he was a kid. You saw it with Taylor Swift, maybe 10 years ago or something like that. I feel like this is a very common trend to really come for young singers. And we're going to go into what it is I think these people are talking about in this particular clip. I want to read a few more comments because I want to get to the core of it. So crazy. Like the facial expressions. Hope she's not hurting too much. It says, Doug, the divorced man with an American flag is the banner.
Okay.
Holy shit. Music stinks this generation. Person with a flower profile picture over here. I feel like you know a lot about someone based off of the non-facial image that they post in their profile picture on Facebook. It really tells you a lot about the person. Fun new game. Click on the profile from any negative comments or this thread and try not to find a leather clad biker photo, someone from Texas, a religious quote, a pastor, or a military emblem, and go. Not that there's anything wrong with any of those things, unless you're from Texas.
Don't you dare take the name of Texas in vain.
Am I the only one bothered by the way the mouth moves when she sings? It's weird. Is it? It's not. It's perfectly normal the way you're... What do you mean? Really? That's what we're going to at this point? The way her mouth moves when she sings. Okay. I don't know who told you. You know how to sing. But they lie to you. You suck.
No. I wish you could see the picture.
I'm not about to put people on blast, though, but come on. Damn, auto-tune does wonders. Disgusting. Enforces so many negative emotions.
Oh my god!
What the hell is this? Okay, we can show this one. There's no way this is actually the person. Holy shit. What is this? Okay, anyway. I can't find it anymore, but there was another commenter that was posting in response to everyone that she needs to be auto-tuned because she's flat. There are a few comments that are saying that she's flat, and I think that people are allowed to like whatever they want. Look, don't get me wrong. I don't care if someone doesn't like her singing or they do like it, but people are saying that this clip is flat. I don't know if that's the right term for it. It's not supposed to be on the pitch. That's not how this song is sung. Like, all of these notes are very bendy and weird. It's a weird song. Jesus. So first of all, I think her voice sounds fine. I think the way she moves her mouth is fine.
So when you're gonna tell her we did that too.
You know what else I think it is that people don't like? I think a lot of people don't like their outfits and the fact that it's an all-female group. Am I crazy? I think, like, there's something internal that, like, triggers in their mind and they don't know what it is that's upsetting them exactly, but I think that's definitely part of it, but whatever. Anyway, that's neither here nor there.
So when you're gonna tell...
This note is supposed to be flat.
Tell her...
Because if she went, because when you're gonna tell her... And the notes were completely that. That's not the song. The song has these bendy notes. It's supposed to freaking bend. It's supposed to be kind of flat and bend up into the note. Everywhere.
Tell her.
Right? It's a weird song. It's supposed to do that. Holy shit.
We did that too. She thinks it's special. But it's so reused. That was the show.
This is the other thing that drives me crazy about people that don't know anything about singing. If they don't like something, they'll say it's off key and it needs auto-tune. Maybe they don't like something else about it. Maybe they don't like her outfit. Maybe they don't like the tone of voice she uses. But the only thing that people who don't know anything about singing know about singing is that things can be off pitch. That's like the first layer of insult. The second layer is that the person needs to use their diaphragm. These are two general insults that people use against a singer when they don't know anything about singing. The diaphragm thing is a whole different can of worms. Sometimes that might actually be the issue. But I would say 90% of the time when there's a comment on the internet telling someone that they're not singing with their diaphragm, it's wrong. And the same often goes as well for this, oh, they're singing off key. I bet that if we plugged her into some sort of software that would measure her pitches, she would be basically on pitch for the notes that she wants to be on pitch for.
Oh my God.
They're supposed to be bendy notes, right? That's supposed to bend.
Deja vu, oh.
Right? It's supposed to, it's supposed to just be kind of like a cry noise. It's not meant to be,
you get deja vu, oh.
Right? It's not, oh my God, this isn't church. This isn't Sunday mass. Oh my God. Anyway, I just wanted to share this with you guys. This kind of shit gets to me. It gets to me. I don't know why. It's just so insanely triggering. I wouldn't be so upset by it if people were able to clearly articulate what they did and did not like about it, I guess. I mean, if people really want to go through that much effort into posting on Facebook, fine. If someone was like, well, you know what? I think that, you know, she has too many of these vocal bends and I don't like that style. And also her tone is a little bit too bright. I wish it was a little bit darker and fuller or whatever. You know what I mean? Like, then I would be like, okay, fair enough. Oh my God, people are just so dumb. People are just so dumb. Please, somebody save me. And it's not gonna change. It's never gonna change. Nobody's ever gonna learn anything about singing. Anyway, I'm exhausted. Hopefully you enjoyed my react. I don't know, whatever this video is. If I upload it, I don't know where I went with this video. I just ranted and ranted. I've probably been filming for 30 minutes now, but anyway, hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, be sure to check me out. Instagram, TikTok, Patreon. On my Patreon, I'm reacting to the entirety of High School Musical, the musical, the series. I filmed all of season one so far. Just need to edit it, upload it, run season, or episode 5 or so should be out by the time this video is up. Maybe 6. I think 6. God damn it. And the thing is, you know what pisses me off the most about this? Whenever I defend somebody that I think is being unfairly criticized or unfairly attacked, people will then attack me. It's crazy how that works. I don't understand how that works, but it's crazy how it works. I'll take it though. But y'all gotta stick up for me. Nobody ever sticks up for me. We'll see you guys next time. Oh my God. Fuck this. People are so dumb. I tried to block this stupid crap, but it won't let me block it. I guess that's good old Facebook pushing their narrative. What? Holy shit.